Alright, Stewart's High Score Challenge time again, and it's, well, one we all know very well, I'm sure by now. Bobble Bobble, the arcade version, of course. And Matt's the one that chose it this time, and he said it was 5 years ago since it last came up, so that should tell you how long this series has been going on for. I don't think I've been taking part since it first started, but I've been in it for quite a while. I've just been having a hard time trying to do any runs for any of these for some time, but fortunately this is one I can do. I was actually working on it for my own thing to do, because I couldn't do the ones that have been coming up. Anyway, odd coincidence there. I like the game quite a lot. I play it often. Usually the Master System port is just the one I prefer. I play the arcade original here now and then too. I'm not all that great at it, which shouldn't be surprising, but I make a lot of stupid mistakes and you're going to see plenty here. But I do some good stuff like there. I was specifically trying to do is get that kind of start. I still don't know what... I think it's if you kill every enemy that's in a round really fast, you get showered with a lot of bonuses or something. I'm not really sure how it works, so that's part of the problem with this for me too, is not knowing what the hell to do to maximize the score. That and I have a hard time with some of the layouts, as you'll see. So, I just tried my best. I didn't do well, let's be honest. I never really do with any of these. But I'm okay with the end score I got. I could have gotten more and lasted longer, no question, but on one credit and all, I don't know. This is the best I could do. I tried for some time after this. In fact, there was one or two where I did get a higher score, but I did a lot of other dumb stuff. I didn't want to show it, so I went with this one because it was the minimal of that, and the score wasn't all that bad either. And that's about everything I can say for the whole entire thing, other than I probably should have gotten that E a lot sooner. See, I saved myself there, that could have been bad, but then that did. That's what I mean by stupid shit. I could have sworn I hit that thing with the bubble, but apparently it didn't count, so, game said screw me. I don't know. Oddly, I don't have a hard time when the enemies go rage mode and pink and they charge at you. Sometimes I do better with them than when they're just moving around like normal. Although the other goal for me was not running out of time. Because sometimes I do play around and I get the warning, but I usually don't have that happen, so that's one thing at least I could say I do well in this. That definitely helped out right there. And I actually got the candy, which I wanted, and it turns out it was only worth friggin' 100 points. But then I get all this, and I forgot I can't go down the hole, and that's gonna be relevant for another round coming up. Which I hate that, you can't jump down either. It's not one of those games where you push down and you can jump, and it doesn't work. I wanted the water here, but I screwed that up. And then when I finally get it, it doesn't make me ride down, so I can't get all the food, which gives you more points, which is a big part of this. I know that much for sure, definitely, even when I play normally. If you want to get a higher score, you have to get as much of that food as you can, and some of it is worth more than others. And there I go again, screwing up, and I thought I was mashing the blow bubble button fast enough, and it counted and it touched them. No, I go out of my way for this food that's not worth a lot, or that was a shoe, actually. Whatever. Yeah, why a shoe? But then the bananas are worth 500. I don't know. I don't know how to, you know, waiting for the damn thing to progress. I don't know how to maximize score in this. I never have. I just get everything I possibly can, and that's about the best I can do. I would have really liked the water there. That would have helped. Fortunately, I didn't go too far enough away, and I was able to still get them. The one good thing is the fruit and whatever else stays around on screen usually long enough, but at the same time, you gotta watch out what you're doing so you don't run into enemies or they jump into you while you're trying to get that extra shit. And here's another example of a personal thing. I have the upgrade that makes you move faster. It's nice and all, but at the same time, it makes it harder for me anyway to judge where I'm jumping so I can get on stuff. That's what that was all about. Oddly, it's kind of a hindrance for me. I need it, though, because it actually helps with dodging, so it's better I miss the jumps on these platforms than get hit by things. That was really good. If only those pricks didn't throw those rocks, I could have got all of them in one go. And the game would have showered me in its praise. Sort of. Maybe. I missed the one, but I got the other banana. Which was the point. And here's an example of one of the stages of the layouts that usually gives me trouble. Not as much as some other times, but I definitely tried to get the water more than I was able to get, and yeah, that's not what I wanted. The timing was really bad this time with it. I also don't remember what some of the upgrades do, specifically. Like D and E and all the different letters, so I don't know. The one good thing is, though, this is not one of those games where you fall at the bottom into the pit, it kills you. The first time I ever played Bubble Bobble, that's what I assumed, so it didn't go well at all. Fortunately, I know better since. And I really wanted all these strawberries, but I did get them all, I think. I didn't notice any fall down watching it back again. But I'm low on lives and all, so that means I didn't really want to take any risks, and this part's usually really bad for me, but I actually got three of them in bubbles for once, right off the bat. Now, as you'll see, this actually works out, but there's a problem. I thought that the last guy who was pissed off, he'd figure out to go in the middle thing and jump up, but I guess the game isn't smart enough for that. And I took all them out of the water, which is fantastic, and here I am again, wasting all my time trying to get something that's not worth much when I should have just went for the bananas, because I know the bananas are worth 500. I still get them, but they were hanging around for quite a while. Also notice that the top of the stage here looks like a ship. Referencing. I wish you'd just drop bananas for you, 500 each time, that would be great. So, almost at the end now, so you know that means I screwed up some monumental way, and here's a pain in the ass stage. It might look like a happy face, but I'm not happy with it. Only 150 for a coin on cob. And here I go again. There's no way out, not that I know of, I still don't. So the only way to do it is kill myself. That's what I mean by stupid mistakes. Now, I did try doing this over and over again just to get to this point, so I didn't do something like that, but I did it twice, two other times. Even though one other time I did get a higher score than this, but I still played worse overall. And that's what I meant in the beginning when I went on about that. If there is a way to get out of putting yourself down here, I don't know what it is. And there you go, I did the same thing again and got myself killed, but I felt I could have took him out with the water. I don't know. I said I wasn't good at it, and I'm not. I just like playing it for fun, but I can't use continues here, so yeah, I can't play my normal way. And that's how you see how unimpressive I am. Anyway, that's it. Thanks for watching, and I will see you later.